almost heaven. West Virginia, Ruby's Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, old on the streets, yonder them mountains, blowing like the breeze. Country road, take home. My mama, take me home, country roads. All my memories, they gather around her. Mine is a lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky. Misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, my mama, take me home. Country roads, take me home down country roads.
Much, Ted, for coming out here to Acton, Massachusetts. Do you like it here?
Ah, loving it.
Played other places around here.
Yeah, first time in Acton. Been to the Boston area and around Massachusetts a little bit, but this is a very nice area here. Excited to be here.
Yeah, we're very excited to have Ted. We booked you, almost a year ago at our new space here at 50 Audubon Drive. This is our second sold-out concert, ticketed concert that we've done, and we are looking forward to when the clock ticks tonight at 7:30 when you start your concert performance.
Yeah, it's going to be far out.
Because nobody's here while we're doing this little unplugged session. What's going to be your starting song?
Well, I like to start it off on a high note, a Rocky Mountain high note.
How did you get started with this tribute to John Denver?
Well, it really started back in 2006. I went to a singing contest in Laughlin, Nevada. And I was in the rock and pop category, but they said, you can also join the country category. So I did. And long story short, I got the nickname Denver in the halls. And people said, man, you really got to think about singing a John Denver song. So I did. I got a standing ovation. And then I ended up going back in for the final and doing Rocky Mountain High and won first place in a national singing contest in Laughlin, Nevada. And so after that, I had some friends that said, you should think about doing a tribute show. So I opened for a guy that does Elvis back at Washington State, and it just kind of took off from there.
Wow, and when I've looked on your website, I am so impressed. You've performed internationally. What is the best country outside of the United States that you've performed?
I got to say it's a toss-up between Jamaica and Australia. The beautiful beaches, the wonderful people, the great food, and the awesome audiences. They really love the Western music. And Australia, I was there from May to June this last year, 2019. And I was there with the Willie Nelson tribute and Johnny Cash. They called it the Kings of Country Tour. That was a lot of fun. So that was probably my top.
And I bet you stole the show, too, because I'm sitting here, I'm just in shock how much you look like John Denver, sounds like John Denver, and I'm very excited for your performance tonight.
Great, I am too. Yeah, this is going to be a really intimate, warm, fun time. I get the crowd involved and do some singing along. I actually get people up on stage for Grandma's Feather Bed, so that's going to be a lot of fun.
I won't tell anybody.
Don't tell them.
I promise, I won't break the secret. Have you loved John Denver your whole life? How did it all start?
I grew up with the music. My mom was a huge fan, and I've always loved to sing. And so it was really something that came very natural. I had to learn to play the guitar. I was a rock and roll drummer all through high school. I played in bands. When I got out of high school, we did some, you know, nightclubs and stuff like that, dance, music, rock. But I always loved to sing. And so when I started doing the tribute after I won the contest in 2006, I had to learn how to play the guitar. And so that was really a challenge, you know, learning to play the guitar as an adult and being a drummer. But it just sort of took off. And I got to tour with Steve Weisberg for 4.5 years, he was John Denver's lead guitar player back in the 1970s, 73 to 77. And so he helped me a lot on my guitar journey.
So you had the inside track when you got started. That's wonderful.
Yeah, that was really cool.
So in my background a little bit, a song that I always sing to my children when they were going to bed at night before they grew up was Sunshine on My Shoulder. I can't imagine how many people sing that song to their children at night as a lullaby. How about you?
Oh, beautiful. Yeah. My kids, my grandkids, I have grandkids. I have 8 grandkids, believe it or not.
I would never believe it.
And I sing to them, and they love it when Grandpa sings.
Yeah. So, Ted, tell me about where you're from.
I was born in Seattle, Washington. And I grew up in Olympia, the capital city. And so I had a great childhood, riding my bike around town, down to the Capitol Lake, and fishing and swimming. And so I had a really great childhood, and I grew up on lots of music. A lot of my influences were John Denver, Jim Croce, James Taylor, and I really love the Eagles and bands like that with all the vocal harmonies and all the great singer-songwriters. So that's a lot where I'm influenced by, but I also love my rock and roll.
Yeah.
And I played in rock bands since I was a teenager, and I'm a drummer as well. So, you know, I like bands like, you know, in the 80s when I was in high school, Bon Jovi, Def Leppard, Scorpions.
Yeah.
Never forget the Ted Nugent concert that I went to. And he comes out on the stage in a loincloth, and he comes flying in on a rope. Like Tarzan. So, you know, I love all kinds of music, but I especially love songs that speak from the heart and identify with people and what people are going through as humans. I love it.
So when you leave Acton after tonight, where are you headed off to?
I'm actually heading back to my home state, Washington State. I'm doing a fundraiser for families that have become homeless. And it's called Family Promise, and I'm excited about that. That's in Aberdeen, Washington, actually Holquim. And then I have another show in Washington State, and then I'm off to Arizona, more warm weather.
Nice.
And I think the highlight of this coming year is going to be when we go to Ireland and Norway and Switzerland. So I'm really excited for that.
That is very exciting.
Yeah.
So when everyone leaves home tonight, they're going to be wanting to listen to you some more. Where are they going to find all your contact information? And if you haven't seen Ted perform, you need to make sure when we have him back that you come to our recreation department office or you go to Nara Park.
Yeah. So people can contact me at tedvigil.com. And I'm also on social media if they want to find me on Facebook. And I post all kinds of fun and silly pictures from the shows and things like that on my Facebook account. And so that's the best way to find out where I'm at. My schedule's on there. It says where I'm going to play at tedvigil.com.
Well, thank you so much, Ted. I know that you're going to take it away and you're going to play some music. We're very excited. And I'd like to give a shout out to Acton TV to thank them for helping us to recognize that Ted is here, our new space, that we can have these great concerts and how great a job everyone at Acton TV does. Thank you.
All right.
And
cool.
Ted, I can't wait to hear you play.
Super. This is my wish for everyone of you. Your days are filled with lots of sunshine. Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy. Sunshine in my eyes can make me cry. Sunshine on the world looks so lovely. Yes, it does. Sunshine almost always makes me high. If I had a day that I could give you, I'd give to you a
today, just like today. And if I had a song that I could sing for you, I'd sing a song to make you feel this way. Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy. My eyes can make me cry. Sunshine on the water looks so lovely. Sunshine almost always makes me high. If I had a tale that I could tell you, I'd tell a tale sure to make you smile. I could wish for you. I'd make a wish for sunshine on the horizon. Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy. Sunshine in my eyes can make me cry. Sunshine on the water looks so lovely. Sunshine almost always makes me high. Sunshine almost all the time makes me high.
Station wagon we used to have had a push button shifter on it, which was very amazing to me when I was a kid. It had an 8-track tape player in it. It's a classic. But when my grandpa, when my grandfather drove into the driveway with that car, it was a 2-tone car, blue and rust. I think I was 11 and my sister was 13, my older sister. And my grandpa came in and said, "Bill, I just got a brand new station wagon. I'm gonna give you this car." And my sister and I went, "No! We can't ride around in that." So I remember we kind of slumped down in the, you know, we'd go down the driveway and we kind of slinked down. So nobody would see us. Man, I wish I had that car right now. What a cool car. Big fins in the back. It's funny how things change. Now, John Denver, before he was John Denver, his name was Henry John Dutchendorf, Jr. His His dad was an Air Force pilot, a very, very good pilot, and he named him Henry John Gutchendorf Jr. Well, John had different ideas about his name and his career and what he was going to do. He grew his hair out, he started playing his guitar, and he said, "Dad, I'm going into the music business." And, you know, like most dads, responsible dad's son, you need to go to school, you need to go to college, you need to get a real job. That's what my parents told me. And I did. I went to school, high school, and I went to college, and I ended up working for the state of Washington, but there was something in me. I had to play music. And that was John. He just loved to play music, and he loved to connect with people. So he wrote a little song back then, when he was Henry John Gutchendorf Jr. still. And he called it, "Babe, I Hate to Go." And Peter, Paul, and Mary were really coming up in the charts. They picked up his song, and they made it a number one hit song. And it was Peter, Paul, and Mary's only number one hit. They had many hits, but this was a big hit for them. John said he pulled over one time. He heard his song on the radio, driving down the road. He has to pull over. His glasses had fogged up. "My song's on the radio." He got overcome with joy and tears. Little was he to know, his song would be playing on thousands of radio stations all over the world, and he would re-record it. And it was renamed "Leaving on a Jet Plane." You got it. Another great sing-along opportunity. "All my acrobats, I'm ready to go. I'm standing outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking as a reward. The taxi's waiting, he's blowing horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could die. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you wait for me. Never let me go. I don't want to hear you now. I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I need to go. Oh. So many times I let you down. So many times I played around. I tell you now that they don't swim a thing. Every place I go, I'll think of you. Every song I sing, I'll sing of you. When I come back, I'll bring your wedding ring. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. I'm leaving on a jet plane. I don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. Now the time has come to leave you. One more time, let me kiss you. Close your eyes and I'll be on my way. You can dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave you alone. About the times that I won't have to say. Kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you won't wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. And I don't want to hear you now.
I used to work all of Thanksgiving and Christmas because there was a lot of good gigs for me, good paying gigs. And after I started having grandkids, I'm like, you know what, you can't pay me enough not to see those little 2 and 3 year olds grow up. And I come in the door, and it's Grandpa! And they just latch on to me and they don't let go. And I tell you what, it's priceless. I can't put a price on that. So I know they grow up super fast. But man, it was good to be back home again this year. And we had a Christmas tree, grandkids all around. Oh man, good stuff. There's a song about that, being back home again.
There's a storm across the valley. Clouds are rolling in. The afternoon is heavy on your shoulders. There's a truck out on the 40, a mile or more away. The whining of his wheels just makes it colder. He's a power away from heaven. All the prayers up in the sky. And 10 days on the road, I'm barely gone. There's a fire softly burning, and supper's almost cold. But it's the light in your eyes that keeps it warm. Yes, and hey, it's good to be back home again. There's old news to tell you. Honey, how do you spend your time? Tell me, what's the latest thing the neighbors say? And a mother, oh, that's crying. Sunshine made her cry. You felt the baby move just yesterday. And hey, it's good to be back home again. You know it is. Sometimes I'm so far, feels like a long lost friend. Yes, and hey, it's good to be back home again. Your fingers and a soft harmony. Kisses that often fall, how that lights my way. The happiness that living with you brings me. It's the sweetest thing I know of. Spending time with you, it's the little things that make house a home. Like a fire softly burning, and supper's almost cold. But it's the light in your eyes that keeps me warm.
Alright, let me hear you now.
It's good to be back home again. Sometimes it's so far, feels like a long lost. Yes, and hey, it's good to be back home again.
One more time.
Hey, it's so good to be back home again. Sometimes it's so far, feels like a long lost friend of mine. And hey, it's good to be back home. I said, hey, it's so good to be back home again.
So good. Great to hear you guys sing tonight. This song is called Blow Up Your TV, okay? So you echo me. It goes like this. Blow up your TV, blow up your TV. Yes. Throw away the paper, throw away the paper.
paper. Then I sang, move to the country, build you a home. Then it's plant a little garden, plant a little garden. Okay, great. Now, would you hear me sing? Eat a lot of peaches. That's when you go, woo-hoo!
All right, let's give it a shot.
Eat a lot of peaches. Okay, we're ready. Here we go. She was a level-headed dancer on the road to alcohol. Well, I was a lonely soldier on my way to Montreal. She pressed her chest against me. About the time the jukebox broke, she gave me a pat on the back of the neck. These are the words she spoke. Blow up your TV.
Blow up your TV.
Throw away the paper.
Throw away the paper.
Move to the country, you're good. Build you a home. Plant a little garden.
Plant a garden.
Eat a lot of peaches.
Woo!
Got to find Jesus on your own. Sat there at the table and I acted real naive, cause I knew that topless lady had something up her sleeve. She danced around the room a while, she did the hoochie coo, sing a song all night long, telling me what to do. Blow up your TV,
blow up your TV,
throw away the paper,
throw away the paper,
move to the country and build you a home, plant a little garden.
Woo!
Got to find Jesus on your own. Oh, yeah. I was young and hungry and about to leave that place. Just as I was going, she looked me in the face. I said, you must have the answer. No, but I'll give it a try. And to this day, we're living on our way. And here is the reason why. We blew up the TV.
Blew up the TV.
We threw away the paper.
Threw away the paper.
We moved to the country. And we built us a home. We had a lot of children. Had a lot of children. Fed them on peaches.
Woo!
All found Jesus. On the Virginia, my mama, take me home, country roads. All my memories, they gather around her. Mine is a lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine. Teardrop in my...